Fiji Times. Be with the times.
Choto ko pyar, bade ko pranam, namaskar, sat sri akal, adab. What I really mean is love and blessings to all my younger ones and respect to my elders. Today, standing at Sydney Cricket Ground with the living legend himself. Yes, the living legend, Sir Brian
Lara.
As you said, the living legend. Yes, the living legend, Brian Lara. Mr. Lara, welcome to Sydney.
Thank you very much.
Just want to ask you one thing. If you were not a cricketer, what would you have been?
That's a million dollar question. At school, I think I was okay in accounting. I think maybe I could have been an accountant, but maybe a businessman, someone that owns his own small business or something like that. I felt that I like the independence, and the independence that cricket gave me, even today, I don't see myself in an office at 8 to 4 in the afternoon. So I feel it might have been a small business. I don't know what exactly, but making a profit.
You know, there are players, then there are cricket players, then there are the legends, which are very, very few. And today I feel humbled, honored, and privileged to be standing next to you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
We're standing at Sydney Cricket Ground. Any of the memory that comes to your mind first playing here?
The number one memory is my first test match that I was playing at the Sydney Cricket Ground. Turned that into 100, maiden 100, and then into a double century.
Yep.
That experience was just unbelievable, and something that would obviously stay with me for the rest of my life. I even have my daughter named after this ground. So it's it was a great occasion back in 1993, the beginning of 1993, and as I said, something that will never ever leave me.
And these are the moments to be cherished forever, not only for you, but even all the spectators who were there on that particular to watch.
It was a sort of a rain stop match, you know, back and forth. But it was a great test match, and it's for us to pull a draw out of that test match where Australia was sort of in charge after their first inning score. I thought that the spectators were really appreciative of the entire game. You know how it turned out. I suppose my innings. I'm not sure if David Boone or Mark Taylor or some other guys scored some runs. Maybe Steve Waugh as well. But it was a good test match, even though it sort of ended in a draw.
I was born back in India before I migrated to Australia. So any of the memory that you cherish playing in India as well?
Oh yeah, many times I've played in India. I'm not one of my top hunting grounds, you know. Somehow, didn't get things going too well in India. Maybe that's why they love me so much. I didn't really take advantage of the bowling. But it's just a great nation to play cricket. You know, when you go to somewhere and you understand that there's 1.3 billion people, half of them love cricket.
It's a religion.
Yeah, it's their religion. And cricketers are so revered in that country. You really and truly feel that, you know, you're worth something when you go to India.
Lovely, lovely. So any of the bowler of the current generation that you feel would have been threat to the batsmen of your era?
I think there are quite a few bowlers, that are going around. That Rabada is good. They got some really. I mean, Bumrah is very, very special, I think, and a couple of very good spinners as well. So, people talk about this era was better or that era was better. I believe that it's all a relative. I think the game has improved. It has evolved. An Indian bowling attack back 20 years ago can't compare to the Indian bowling attack now. It's much better now. But a West Indies bowling attack in the 80s. The present one can't compare to it. So it's back and forth with certain teams. So I believe that the game has grown, it has evolved, and for the betterment of it. You know, the advent of T20, perfect timing, and now the game has gone to another level.
Not talking about cricket, if I take you back to your childhood, there would be plenty of memories that you want to relive. Any one of them that you want to share, that you want to relive?
Nah, it's just, the opportunity having 11 of us in one house, 6 bigger brothers, 4 sisters and myself, plus my parents.
Would have been fun.
Yeah, those are fun times. And they've gone so quickly. You know, now you've got your own family. Everybody is dispersed in different direction, doing their thing. Those were times that, you cherished. And, if it's one thing you wish you can get back into that environment. Because, it's so honest. There's no baggage. There is nothing you're thinking about.
It's
you're there.
Yeah.
Now you're worried about air condition. You're worried about this. You're worried about that. Back at then, it's no worry. You're there. Your brother's on top of you. One on your left, one on your right is just the best time of my life.
You know, wonderful, wonderful. So how do you see the concept of the day-night test matches?
I know there's been a few over the years. I don't see it as a battle between bat and ball. If it's played at midnight, if it's played at midday, it doesn't matter. You know, both teams have a fair opportunity to get on top of each other. And that is the key at the end of the day. Having a day-night game, maybe offering the opportunity for people to come after work has created some excitement. It's been successful in Adelaide over the years. You know, why not? I don't see anything wrong with it.
If you have to pick one batsman around the world who's currently playing, who's the best batsman?
I don't like naming the best batsman. I think there's some a group of players that are, you know, have stood head and shoulders above the rest. And I'm talking about Virat Kohli, Steve Smith, David Warner in the one-day game, Rohit Sharma in the one-day game. Look what he did in the World Cup. And I appreciate everybody for what they bring to the table.
You know, we talked about Virat Kohli. He's done a wonderful job as a captain. As a coach, do you think he can perform the same way?
As a coach? I don't think he wants to be coach right now. He's very happy in the position that he's in.
Yeah. At some point, would you like to coach any of the international team? If yes, which one?
I don't know. It's a good question. I believe that you know what? My strengths or something that I'd want to get into is more the mental side of it. You know, not the actual technical side or the physical, but more the mental side of sport. And I believe that played a very important part in my career, more than just the natural ability to play. The ability to have that mental strength to face whatever situation there
was. I think the mental strength to face the pressure in front of 50,000 people and the bowler coming on. Yes, indeed. ICC T20 World Cup coming up. Before we wrap up, whom do you think and predict?
I think in these conditions in Australia, I think you'll give them the edge. I think they've got a pretty good team and they would know how to play. They won the 2015 World Cup here in Australia, and I believe that they would start as favourite. But India, you know, a class unit, they know how to play around the world, something that, you know, they may not understand or have understood 20, 30 years ago, but they definitely know what to do now.
Finally, before we go, any message for the budding cricketer that you want to give?
I think for any young cricketer, I think one of the most important things is visualization. You know, I think that helped me a lot, even as a kid, and I didn't even know what I was doing. You know, when, you know, I sort of see myself in a West Indies outfit, in a burgundy cap, visualizing is part of the job. It gives you that impetus to keep going. And if you have a negative approach to that and say, well, you know, I don't think I can do it, then you're not going to do it. So I think I would urge all youngsters to try visualization. I think it's important.
It has been an absolutely pleasure talking to you.
Cheers.
Thank you so much to Adam and Warren Tiwari to Bink on the camera.
Yes.
Ms. Lara, thank you so much.
Thank you.
One-stop answer to your Australian education and visa matters. GEMCO Sydney. Dream big, achieve big.